welcome to Neutral Site Action, and we're just about ready for kickoff. Before we head down to the field for the coin toss, we'd like to remind you this game is brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. And the fans are on their feet awaiting the start of this game as the players line up for the kick. Smith from the 8. Gets to about the 24-yard line. The quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game. The offensive line got a really good push there, allowing the back to pick up 9 on the play.
That makes it 2nd and 2.
And he throws it away. So it's 3rd down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. Throws complete. He's got room to work. Tackle made at the 37.
Hey, it's a first down for this offense that keeps everybody enthusiastic. You can see the momentum that this offense is gaining. The coaches and the players on the sideline are fired up, and hey, it's a new set of downs.
Pass right, running back's got it. Tackle at the 49.
That makes it 1st and 10.
Up the middle for a nice gain.
Gain of 6 yards. That'll bring up 2nd and 3.
Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. And down he goes at the 32.
Williams on the tackle at the 32-yard line. First down.
He guns it left side. Stays in bounds and made a nice catch.
The defenders are really going to have to get their heads into this game. That was a big play, and on 1st down, no less.
So the referee initially calls it a catch, but we'll get a second look at it here and determine if he was in bounds when he hauled it in.
And that play happened so fast that it was very tough to tell if he was able to get a foot down or not.
To review the play, the ruling on the field stands.
So after some discussion, the call on the field stands. 1st and goal. Ball on the 9-yard line. He's tackled just outside the goal line.
That's good for a gain of 8 yards. That brings up 2nd and goal.
And they'll bring him down behind the line.
The D-line did a good job of nullifying out the blocks up front, and that allowed the linebacker to roam free and make the tackle in the backfield.
It's 3rd and goal. Ball on the 3-yard line. They're crowding the line. They'll run it. Touchdown, Bulldogs! Score by the halfback.
And a nice call by the coach there. Just give it to your main man anytime you're near the goal line.
And he tacks on the extra point. A 10-play, 76-yard drive, and they get it in for 7.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
From his own goal line, makes it to the 22-yard line.
Kickoff return, 21 yards.
The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. They bring him down in the backfield.
That was a loss of 2 yards. That'll bring up 2nd and 12.
from their own 20-yard line. Second down. High. Comes away with five there on the option to the fullback.
Job by the defense of getting after that quarterback, and right now I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
Taylor back deep to return. He's at midfield and he's taken down at the 45-yard line. He showed a good burst there.
Brad, let's see if this offense can maintain the rhythm that they established on that last drive. Not just putting points on the board, but driving the length of the field to be able to eventually put points up. I think that's going to be important for them to try to keep that confidence going here on this drive.
That brings up second and five.
Louisiana Tech up 7 points. He's going to try and scramble, and they bring him down for a sack on the play. Third down, and they need to get it down to the 35. He throws. It's going the other way.
Boy, I bet he knew as soon as he released that football that he shouldn't have made the throw. And that's the thing. When you're under that kind of pressure, it takes away that one split second you need to scan the area so you know where it's a safe throw.
First and 10. Ball on their own 24. They'll bring him down around the 33-yard line. The 34-yard line.
They like to sometimes get their fullback involved with option plays to give the defense something extra to think about.
From their own 34-yard line, first down. Here's the pitch, and now he's got the corner. Nice run, and he's brought down.
That's a gain of 6 on the play. That brings up second and 5.
About the 43-yard line.
Call it a gain of 3 yards. That'll bring up 32.
It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. And they get him in the backfield for a loss.
Call a loss of 2 yards on the play. That makes it 4th and 4.
Taylor is the deep man awaiting the return. Taylor takes it to 23. He makes it out to maybe the 33-yard line. Louisiana Tech
showing no fear early in this football game, Kirk, and they're looking for the upset.
They are looking for the upset. And the longer they stick around in a game like this, I think the more that they believe they can actually pull it off. It looks like we may have ourselves a ball game here.
Louisiana Tech is up 7. He gets out to about the 35-yard line.
That makes it 7-8.
He makes it to the 35-yard line.
That makes it 7-7.
Looks for his running back, incomplete.
Was the intended receiver on the play. That brings up fourth and seven.
The punt upcoming, and they're going to come after this one. Room around the corner. He makes it to the 45-yard line. The Bulldogs are looking downright scary on defense so far, Herbie.
They are flying around as a group right now, completely aware of what this offense is trying to do and dismantling them every single time on every single play.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their mind. They just need to go out there and play.
You know, these backwards plays can have a psychological impact. It can damage a team's confidence if it keeps happening.
Second and 13. Ball on the 42-yard line. And he's taken down at the 45.
That makes it first and 10.
Nice run to the outside. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. They go to the left for a nice gain. Six-yard line.
Think about the speed and instincts it takes for a linebacker to get from his position into the backfield to make a play like that. That's well done.
From the 36-yard line, second down. And he's tackled around the 38-yard line.
That's a loss of 2 yards on the play. That brings up third and 14.
Around the 28-yard line.
That was a well-designed and executed pattern, but on third down and forever, it just wasn't enough.
Looks like they've decided to go for it here. First down grab by the receiver. Tackle made at the 21-yard line. We're at play number 9 of this current drive. On the play.
Loss of 3 yards on the play. That'll bring up second and 12.
From the 24-yard line, second down. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. Not a lot of offense in quarter number 1, but nonetheless, we've got a close game. Louisiana Tech leads it 7-0. And we're ready for more football here in quarter number 2. Flips it middle to the running back. Nice play to set up first and goal. First and goal from the 4. They're knocking on the door. Touchdown, Navy! Great play there to pick up 6 points.
Yeah, this guy is tough in medium yardage situations. Everybody's thinking the quarterback is going to keep it, and the big fella makes his way into the end zone.
And he adds the extra point. Navy to kick. From the 8-yard line. Tackle made at the 30-yard line. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. Completes it, and he's hit hard immediately. Wide receiver screen play. Tackle right around the 42-yard line. And they've got the dime package in there to try and deal with this five-receiver look. He gets out to about the 45-yard line. That'll make it 7-7. Tackled for a loss.
You can't teach instinct. The ability to know where a play is going is something this safety has. That was a terrific effort.
Third down, and they need to get it inside the 48. And he is drilled at the 29-yard line.
Boy, this pass rush is sometimes scary. They're really getting after the quarterback now.
Signals for a fair catch.
Fair catch made at the 36-yard line.
They've been like a couple of fighters feeling each other out so far. Let's see if they start to open it up a little bit more now. Knocked out of bounds at the 36-yard line. Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 36. He's under some heat. Quick throw. And he tackles him hard at the 33-yard line. Now it's first and 10 with the defense trying to regroup after giving up the big pass. Trying to do a little too much by himself.
Hey, maybe next time he'll get it out to the back so he can do something with it.
On the pitch, look out, loose ball. Gets out to around the 28. So it's third down now, and they're going to need about four. He throws right. Got it. Complete. He's out of bounds.
That makes it first and goal.
It out to maybe the 7-yard line.
This is the eighth play of the drive. Touchdown, Midshipman. Great play there on the option.
Near the end zone, this fullback is great at doing a lot of the dirty work.
And he hits the PAT. It was an eight-play, 65-yard drive, and they put up 7 points. So our score, 14-7. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He's to the 20. And he's tackled at the 28-yard line. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Run there as they work the outside.
That'll bring up second and three.
Got some open field. He makes his way to about the 45.
That's good for a gain of 11 yards. First down.
After a decent pickup.
That's good for a gain of 7 yards. That'll make it second and four.
He gets rid of this one.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
They're about 4 yards away here on third down. Tries to buy some time, and down he goes at the 43.
That makes it first and 10.
Catches it, and that's all. The blockers and drag the quarterback down.
Boy, excellent play by the defense here. A few extra seconds and those receivers might have been open.
From the 35-yard line, it's second down. They'll knock him down for a loss. And this is the 10th play of the drive. He wants it all going long.
What a huge letdown by the defense on a big third down play. Man, that is just inexcusable.
He's tackled right around the 2-yard line. And they got to him before he could get back to the line. And this is the 13th play of this drive. five wide. Quick shot. The defender tips it away. This one should be makeable. Looks like he flinched down there on the line.
False start, offense.
Just a mental lapse, but it's going to cost him 5 yards.
Still fourth down.
The kick is up,
and he got it.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding him to a field goal right there.
Barnes has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off. From the 7, gets out to about the 21. The quarterback is on his way back onto the field, and he led a great drive last time out. Navy is up 4. They'll bring him down at about the 33-yard line. From their own 33-yard line, first down. Inside the 30. He might have a chance for the 10. Touchdown, Bulldogs.
How about the play by the defender? That was a great interception and an even better effort to bring the ball back for a touchdown.
So the kicker will line up here and try to give his team a 3-point lead with this extra point. He splits the uprights with the extra point. Louisiana Tech is lining up to kick this one off. Walker from the 4. He makes it to the 28-yard line. Navy's offense struggled in that first quarter, but, man, they've really come to life here in quarter number 2.
Well, they've hit their stride here offensively. If they could just have their own defense try to come up with a stop or two, they'd have the lead right now.
So the offense will come back out onto the field, hoping for a little better result than that last pick 6.
Brad, I know they turned the ball over the last time that they were out here, but it's important for these guys to remember they still have the lead here. Even though the momentum right now might be facing against them, they've got to be able to just settle down and find some confidence in being able to reestablish who they are.
From their own 38-yard line, first down. Down around the 42-yard line. He's taken down right around the 22-yard line.
It really wasn't badly played by the defense, but sometimes a good throw and catch just beats you.
Gets it. He's in space. And that sets them up for the first and goal. Navy will take a timeout. That's their second of the half. First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. Touchdown, Navy! Nice job by the offense to get the final few yards to the end zone.
Yeah, they knew what play to call for in that situation and made it work.
Converts the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick.
And he'll return this one from the 7. He's out to the 30. And down at the 34.
Well, this is a very competitive game. Just when you think one team has gained the advantage or the momentum, the other team comes fighting back, and it's going back and forth. This is almost like a basketball game.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays.
Complete. What a catch.
And he's tackled around the 48-yard line. Louisiana Tech is going to take their first time out of the half. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 48. He's going to try and scramble. And he's sacked. The Bulldogs use their second timeout. There's sack number 4.
Well, he's being forced to make really quick decisions because he doesn't have any time to throw the ball. That's going to lead to turnover.
Going deep.
And they make the stop at the 10. He scrambles, decides to tuck it in, and he's got space. And he hits him hard at the 5-yard line.
That's a big problem to play. That'll make it 2nd and 4.
He's scrambling. They'll make the sack. Louisiana Tech will use their final timeout from the 9-yard line. It's 3rd down. Kicks away, and it's through the uprights.
Wow, what an offensive display by both teams in the first half. 21-20, Midshipmen.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes.
Good thing we have these spectacular 1080p high-definition monitors in here. All the better to see these offenses execute with precision in the first half.
Yeah, I like having the old-school black-and-white TVs, too, that show a little bit of defense occasionally. But, yeah, offensive plethora. I mean, you want to see how to dial up a clinic on how to play offense? You saw it on both sides in the first half. I'm not sure that there was much resistance, but it's always fun to be able to dial a play up and know that it's going to work. And every single time you go, hey, this plays money, this plays money, this plays money, and you saw it over and over.
That'll do it here in the studio at halftime. We'll try to see if Pollack can bring a little energy in the second half. Got a lot of games to watch, including yours. Brad and Kirk, ready for the second half.
All right, Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half.
Number 28, back to return.
From his own goal line, he's to the 20. He gets out to about the 25-yard line. Kirk, you and I like seeing points. We're seeing points in this third quarter. This has been fun.
And I think it's going to continue, Brad. I think the adjustments that were made at halftime have allowed these quarterbacks to go out and really be able to take command of how they want to attack each defense. It's going to come down to that final drive.
They're ready to begin another drive. Navy with a 1-point lead. The 36. From their own 36-yard line, it's 1st down. And he carries the ball for a nice gain. Looking for the corner. He's at the 40. And he's shoved out of bounds at the 35.
That makes it 1st and 10.
First and 10. Ball on the 35.
the middle.
That brings up second and five.
And they get nice yardage on that run.
So it's third down, and they're just inches away from picking up the first down.
Tackle at about the 17-yard line. Navy is up one. He laterals the ball. Touchdown, midshipman.
Nobody picked up the running back on that option play.
The defense is so concerned about the quarterback's ability to create that they left a halfback all alone. And once he took the pitch, there wasn't anything between him and the goal line.
And he tacks on the extra point.
A seven-play, 75-yard drive, and they get it in for seven.
Brad, not only did they put points up on the board, but I think it's the way they did it. That could be demoralizing for a defense.
He gets out to about the 28-yard line.
For Navy, they've been bringing the heat, and they've gotten to him on several occasions. This aggressive defense has enjoyed multiple sacks tonight.
They also have that one takeaway.
They're still allowing the passing game to click.
Well, when you come after the quarterback and you don't get there, it usually leaves somebody open, or at least some space to work with.
The defense wants to dig in here to avoid any letdowns. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense.
Quick throw, and down he goes, right around the 40. Knocked out of bounds,
right around the 42-yard line.
That makes it second and eight.
Scrambling around. He's wrapped up for the sack.
That'll make it third and nine.
Third down now, and they need to get it out to the 50.
Completely stopped immediately. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Pretty good looking touchdown drive the last time these guys were out there.
Navy holds an 8-point advantage. He fights forward to about the 20.
From their own 20-yard line, second down.
Here's an opening. He's out to the 30. Makes it out to about the 36.
That brings
from their own 33-yard line. Second down. He's at midfield. Makes it out to about the 46. He gets out to about the 37-yard line.
Second and one.
Short yardage situation here. It's second down and one. Nice run to the outside. Navy up by eight.
That's good for a gain of 4 yards. That makes it second and six.
And this is the eighth play of the drive.
Hey, let's get this, get this. Mike six. Mike six. Go. Go.
Good outside run there. The option to the tailback, good for about 4 yards. So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. Tries to pitch it, and now the ball is loose. And they fall on the loose ball. Kirk, what happened on the option play there?
Well, you got to give credit to the defense. They knew what was coming, and they came up and made the play.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing.
Let's go! Ride 68!
Three. Catches it, and he's looking for more. They'll bring him down at the 48.
That makes it first and 10.
Throws to the tight end, and that ball's incomplete. From the 48-yard line, second down. In the shotgun and five wideouts. He's tackled at the 42-yard line. They'll get 6 yards.
You get 6 yards, and that makes picking up a first down very reasonable.
Defensive coordinator anticipating this five-wide set, and he comes in with his dime package. Brought down at the 32-yard line.
Part of the game of 10 yards. First down.
Dangerous throw. This one's picked off. He's at the 20, inside the 10, and he will score. So a great play by the defender to give his team 6 points.
That was a very good play, and that will certainly help build his team's momentum.
And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. And he's tackled at the 27.
Kirk, this defensive lineman has made a statement with his play tonight.
You know, you hear a lot of coaches talk about a ball hawk. Well, this is a classic example of a young man that just has a feel, who always seems to be able to make plays for this defense. I think it has a lot to do with the way they're pressuring the quarterback. They're just doing a great job as a unit and not allowing this quarterback to get into any rhythm.
If you want to point to certain individuals as reasons why they're winning, he'd be a good start.
So the offense will come back out onto the field, hoping for a little better result than that last pick six.
This quarterback needs to be a little bit more careful because this defense is excellent on capitalizing off the mistakes.
And he's taken down at the 49-yard line. A nice-looking play that time.
Well, the defense was blitzing here, and again, great recognition by the quarterback to find the hot receiver.
They try to get a head start there.
False start, offense.
Little stumbles like these can kill your offensive progress.
Still first down.
So the penalty will make it first and 15.
Got a man, watch out here. He's taken down around the 49-yard line.
I think he's got a good rhythm going right now with his wide receivers. He hit him for a nice game.
Gets to about the 47-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 2 yards. Running in the 46.
Now he tries to buy some time. Slides down, and he just slid down to avoid the contact there.
You know, Brad, sometimes a quarterback's got to get down low to protect himself. But in this case, try to show some guts. Break a tackle and get downfield. Look for the first down.
Certainly, they don't have the return on here. Navy showing right now that they are not content to sit back and just watch their lead disappear. They're adding to it.
Boy, they're clicking right now on offense. They found their rhythm, and as you said, they're not looking back. They're trying to extend this lead and try to put this game out of reach.
And here we go with the offense ready to get things going again. Tackles him hard at the 6.
Gain of 3 yards. That'll make it 2nd and 7. Larry.
It's 2nd down, 7 to go. Ball on the 6-yard line. Tackle after a decent run up the gut.
That's a gain of 4. 3rd down.
Pitch, and he's got some room. He's pushed out of bounds.
Right around the 18-yard line.
That makes it 1st and 10.
1st and 10. Ball on the 18-yard line. And they make the stop around the 18-yard line.
No gain. That'll bring up 2nd and 11.
That's 3 down and 1 to go. Navy's up by 15. All right, we're just about set to start action here again in the 4th quarter. And they got him for a loss.
Loss of 1.
And here's another 3rd down.
Hey, block 28.
Defense coming and the ball comes out. It's recovered. They've got to be happy after recovering that fumble.
Yeah, because a play like that gets the defense right back into the game. You'll probably see them get real conservative now.
The sack makes this a 4th and very long. Taylor, back to return it. Taylor fields it at the 50. He makes it to the 32-yard line. It's going to be interesting to see how the action shakes out in this series.
almost intercepted there.
As a defender, you want to keep your hands up. Maybe you can come away with a pick or at least deflect the ball.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 32-yard line. Throws. Fires quickly, and he's got his receiver for the touchdown. Wow, an almost impossible pass to defend, and it goes for six.
Yep, the defense would have needed 12 guys on the field that time.
So the offense is going to go for two. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. And they get the two. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He's to the 20. And he's taken down at the 26. You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. Navy is up by a touchdown. He might have a chance. Gains his way to the 36-yard line. From their own 36-yard line. First down. Quick out to his receiver. And they push him out at the 45. Down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. He knows how to run inside the 30. He gets hit out of bounds around the 22-yard line. Down and 10 to go after the big gain on the run. And he's tackled around the 14-yard line.
That'll bring up second and three.
Play as you'll ever see.
It took all fall practice for the quarterback and the halfback to get their timing down. Man, do they look good now.
He makes the PAT. They line up to kick this one away. Smith fields it at the 2. He's to the 20. He gets out to about the 25-yard line. And as the defense comes back out, you can be sure they're thinking about that score they surrendered the last time around.
As long as this quarterback has time to throw, you can guarantee that he'll find the open man.
They bring him down. From their own 21-yard line, it's second down. Tackle made at about the 21.
That brings up third and 14.
sack.
Brad, not only did they give up a sack here, but their quarterback just got hit and hit hard. If I'm an offensive coordinator, especially an offensive line coach, I'm getting a hold of my offensive line, making sure these guys are on the same page, and they've got to take more pride in taking care of their quarterback than that play right there.
Fourth and long here after the sack. The punting team's got to give their kicker some time. It's a short kick. He's got the corner. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line.
When you're a quarterback and you start this close to the end zone, your eyes just light up when you take the field. Conversely, the defense is thinking, uh-oh, we can't let him get another one so quickly.
Tackle at the 27-yard line.
That's a gain of two on the play. That makes it second and eight.
From the 27-yard line, it's second down. About the 29-yard line.
You've got to admire the intensity that these linebackers bring to the table. As soon as he saw it was staying on the ground, he made a beeline for the ball carrier.
Oh, here we go. Oh.
He guns it to the left.
Great job by the defense at getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
They're going to try a long field goal here. It's up, looks long enough, and he missed it left. No good. And they come away empty-handed.
Usually in rainy conditions, it's a bad snap or hold that's the problem. But everything looked good to me. You can place the blame solely on the kicker right there.
So they're just about set to get the game going again.
At second and six.
And they get nice yardage on that run. Higgins gains about 5 yards on the option play. He fights forward to about the 40.
First and ten.
And he hits him hard at the 33-yard line.
Loss of 7 yards on the play. That'll make it second and long.
They find themselves in a hole here after that sack at second and long. Rid of it. The quarterback in the gun with five receivers. Throwing left. Got him. For the 20. For the 10. Touchdown, Bulldogs.
White out here truly knows what he has to do to contribute to make his team successful.
Where was the coverage there? There wasn't anybody near him at all. And he adds the extra point. A six-play, 72-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
Caught at the 8. Gets to about the 27-yard line. Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. Just under 3 to go in regulation. Nice run up the middle.
He's got himself a 100-yard rushing performance.
I doubt they planned on him taking it to him like this, but he's a very good athlete for a guy of his size.
It's second and five here.
Ball on their own 33.
Looks like someone got a head start on the line.
False start, offense.
You got to be careful to avoid these. Penalties are a great way to stall out a drive.
Second down, 10 to go.
Ball on the 28-yard line.
They'll bring him down at the 30-yard line. The Bulldogs taking their first time out of the half. So the quarterback keeps it for 2 yards. He's going to try and scramble. He's tackled around the 34-yard line. Louisiana Tech's going to have to use their second time out of the half.
That brings up fourth and three.
Taylor awaiting the return. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. Fielded at the 19. He gets out to about the 32-yard line. And here comes the offense again. They'll try to make it 2 touchdowns in 2 possessions.
This quarterback right now is in a rhythm, and a lot of that has to do with his preparation. You can see right now with the reads that he's being able to make, getting the football out of his hands, that he's feeling very, very confident in his ability to throw the football against this defense.
Was the intended receiver on the play.
From their own 32-yard line. Second down. Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. Throws to the back quickly, off his hands, incomplete.
The intended receiver on the play. Third down.
Needed that play, and he dropped it.
Boy, the defensive coordinator and the defense has to be very proud of their efforts and what they've been able to do to rattle this quarterback. He's really struggled on this drive. Now here they are facing a fourth down.
And they've got all their DBs in there to match up against the 5-wide set. Throwing right, in and out of his hands.
It's always a gamble going for it with so many yards to come up with. But when you're behind, sometimes you have to take risks to get back into a ball game.
You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. He's taken down at the 35-yard line. Louisiana Tech will take their last time out. Second down, 13 yards to go. Ball on the 35-yard line. So he holds on to it and gets a good 5 yards. He's in trouble. Quick throw.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
Looks like they've decided to go for it here. Under a minute left in the game. Here comes the pressure. Dumps it complete. It's the fullback over the middle. And he is drilled at the 21. You should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. He takes a knee. so this one goes final. A hard-fought, close game.
Navy, 42. Louisiana Tech, 35. The Bulldogs.
That brings this broadcast to a close. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.